Once upon a time, there was a little ogre named Shrek who lived with his family in a small bog by a tree. It was a pretty nasty place, but he was happy because ogres like nasty. On the ogre's 7th birthday, his parents sat him down to talk, just like all ogre parents did for hundreds of years before.
Listen, son, you're growing up so quickly. Growing up bigger by the day.
Although we want you here, the rules are very clear.
Now you're 7.
Now you're 7, so it's time to go away. Your mama packed a sandwich for your trip.
Your papa packed your boots in case of snow.
You're gonna make us proud, no backing up allowed.
Just keep walking.
Just keep walking, and you'll find somewhere to go. It's a big, bright, beautiful world with happiness. It's peaches and cream, and every dream comes true. But not for you. It's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere. And just around the bend, there's a friend or two. But not for you.
You're ugly, son, which means that life is harder. People hate the things they cannot understand.
And when they look at us, they tend to make a fuss.
Burn our houses down.
And chase us off our land. It's important that you find a cozy cesspit,
a place no one would ever dare to tread.
And if they happen by, make sure you terrify them.
If you don't, son,
then you'll surely wind up dead.
So, the little ogre went off and found himself a muddy patch of swampland, far, far away from the world that despised him. And there he stayed for many years, tucked away and all alone, which was just the way he liked it. Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I'm happy where I am, all alone. I got all I need, so read the stinking sign. Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I party on my own anyway. Doing what I can with a one-man conga line. Yeah, your big, bright, beautiful world. It's full of teddy bears and unicorns. Take your fluffy fun and shove it where the sun don't shine. I prefer a life like this. It's not that complicated. Sure, I'm fated to be lonely, and I'm destined to be hated. If you read the books, they say it's why I was created. But I don't care. The world, it's not a big, bright, beautiful world, but it's mine. Alone, it's mine, and it's mine.
on, keep it moving. Let's go, come on, you follow me. You stay over here, you bunch. You with the nose, come on. You over there, you follow me this way. Come on, keep it moving. Keep it moving, come on. Don't mind the mud. You'll get used to it.
This place is a dump.
It isn't fit for a pig.
It's awful.
Pig deep breaths, brother.
Panic attacks.
He needs some Paxil.
Look, you all read Lord Farquaad's decree.
Yeah, we read it. All fairy tale creatures have been banished from the kingdom of Duloc. All fruitcakes and all freaks will be sent away. Resettlement facility.
Oh, no. Looks like a better treat Orbit and Expedia to cancel my kayak trip.
It smells like butt!
All right, when I call your name, step forward. Pinocchio, the puppet. That's your patch of mud down there. Fairy Godmother.
Right here.
Little Miss Muffet.
Present.
Little Bo Peep.
Jumped on a swamp. Man, I tell you, sometimes being a fairy tale creature sucks pine sap. Life is disappointing. Whoa, is what I know. Outie by my nose. That's just how it goes.
Three bears, you'll take your spot here by Pinocchio. No, that's too close. Too far. Ah, just right.
Strife is never ending.
Peter Pan.
Banished from the town.
Ugly duckling.
They dragged me from the pond.
They broke my magic wand.
They blew our condos down.
Wicked witch.
Life is but a witch hunt.
Mama's in the mud. Mama's in distress.
Then who lichuled my hat?
They said that we were fat.
They tore my cotton granny dress and called me a honey and tranny mess.
Sugar plum fairy.
Story of my life. Booty from the bar.
If we find you back in the kingdom, you will be executed!
I always dream I get a happy ending.
And it's right here, not how it goes.
I always dream I get an ever after. If this is it, it blows, it blows, it blows.
This is worse than the time I got the bitch of the season, Tijuana.
Story of my life, all the wasted bread.
What are you doing in my swamp?
Well, gosh, we were forced to come here.
Oh, yeah? Forced by who?
Lord Farquaad. He hoofed and he poofed and he signed an eviction notice.
Well, not my problem. Now, all of you need to turn around and go back where you came from.
Go back?
Lord Farquaad will turn us into bratwurst.
The guy's bad news.
Maybe you could try talking to him, eh?
Yeah, he listened to you. You're big and really scary.
I'm also an ogre, which is why I stay in my swamp and avoid large crowds. Now, haven't you heard the stories?
Do you mean the same stories that say, I'm a big bad wolf?
Or the ones that say, I'm a wicked witch?
The ones that say, I'm a wooden boy?
Oh my God.
Well, I'm not a wooden boy. I have a glandular condition.
Oh, let it go.
Look here, ogre. I'm going to spell it out for you. We don't want us here any more than you do. You're the only one tough enough to stand up to that no good Flim Flam or Farquaad.
Tough enough? You don't even know me.
I always dreamed I'd get a happy ending.
As it foretold in my horoscope,
can't you help us out with the never after?
Can't you see that you're only hope? You're only hope.
Attention, all fairy tale things. Your welcome has officially worn out. I'm going to find this firecrat guy right now and get you all off my land and back where you came from.
Yay!
Time to say goodbye, time to say farewell. Time for you to fly, it's the very swell. Fasten your surprise, time to say goodbye.
I'll be right back.
Time to say baboose.
Don't get comfortable.
Oh, we're on the loose.
And don't touch mine. Oh, now this can't be right. I'm all turned around. I took a right at the candy house, past the weird old woman in the shoe, and a left at the candlelight pavilion. Huh, what's this? Ah, swamp. Yeah, that's true. Do you look good?
Oh, get that donkey! Watch where you're going, Mary Poppins. I'm okay. I'm all right. You just stay where you are. I'll be fine.
I hear voices over here.
Oh, donkey, how would you?
Wow! Oh, it's hideous.
Now, that's not very nice. It's just a donkey.
Step aside, ogre, and let us at him.
Why, what did he do?
I don't want to die, I don't want to die, I don't want to die.
He's a talking donkey. A freak of nature, as are you, you unsavory beast.
Hey, now. You're going the right way for a smacked bottom, you are.
By the order of Lord Farquaad, I'm authorized to place you both under arrest.
Under arrest, eh? This is the part where you run away. And don't come back!
Can I just say, that was incredible? Man, they were tripping over themselves to get away from you. I like that.
Good, I'm glad. Now, why don't you go celebrate your narrow escape with your friends?
But I don't have any friends.
Now, there's a shocker.
Say, you lost or something?
No, I'm just trying to find the best route to Duloc.
Oh, Duloc? Oh. I know, Duloc. You gotta let me show you the way because I am like a GPS with fur.
I'll be fine on my own. Thanks.
But nobody's fond of their own. Not when you look like we do. Hey, didn't you hear what they said? This place is going Stepford. We gotta join forces, otherwise they're gonna lock me up, and I cannot go back in a cage. I don't know if I mentioned this or not, but I did 6 years in solitary for impersonating a piñata. Wow, that was really scary. And if you don't mind me saying, if that don't work, your breath will certainly get the job done.
Listen, little honky, take a look at me. What am I?
Really green.
No, I'm an ogre, you know. Grab your torches and pitchforks. Doesn't that bother you?
Nope.
Really?
Really, really.
Oh.
Man, I like you. What's your name?
Shrek.
Shrek. Well, you know what I like about you, Shrek? You got that whole, I don't care what anybody thinks of my thing. I like that, Shrek. I respect that. You are all right.
Okay, good. Goodbye.
Hey, I gotta let me go with you. You don't know what it's like to be considered a freak. Okay, well, maybe you do, but that's why we gotta stick together.
Donkey.
No, don't speak. Don't speak. Just hear me out, I might surprise you. I'll be a friend when others despise you. Don't roll your eyes, stop with the moping. You need a pal, my calendar's a pen. I'll bring you soup when you feel congested. I'll bail you out when you get arrested. I got your back when things get scary. And I'll shave it when it gets hairy.
No.
Don't let me go.
Donkey.
Don't let me go.
Hairy.
Don't let me go. You need me. You need me. I'll treat you right and never act shoddy. If you kill a man, I'll hide the body. What do you say? You're not responding. I think we're bonding. Don't let me go.
Donkey.
Don't let me go.
Donkey.
Don't let me go. Oh, 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 oh. You need me. You and me, we belong together. Like butter and grits, like cables and bits, like yin and yang, storm and drang, like ing and chang attached at the hip, but not an old lady hip that might break. I'm gonna be on you like a fat kid on cake.
Ah, no.
Like Cupid and Psyche, like Pop Rocks and Mikey. We'll stick together like that Velcro stuff. I'm the fuzzy side, you'll be the spiky. Ooh, like little kids in pajamas with the front of things at the bottom. You know, feeties, like donuts, I know those are donuts. Oh, donuts and diabetes. You need me. You need me.
On one condition, you keep the jabbering to a minimum.
You got it, man. No jabbering. You will not regret this.
Too late.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Shrek and Donkey, two stalwart friends off on a whirlwind big city adventure.
Let us lay them down. Don't make waves, stay in line, and we'll get along fine. What a terrific surprise. Once upon a time, this place was infested. Freaks on every corner, I had them all arrested. Hey, nonny, 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 no. If you had a court, gah, you didn't pass inspection. We all have our standards, but I will have perfection. And so, things are looking up here in Duloc.
Just take a look.
The things I'm cooking up here in Duloc.
He likes to cook.
A model that amazes, a plan with seven phases.
Bum, 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 bum.
Things are looking up here in Duloc.
They're looking up
in Duloc. The ladies all look swell.
Ah.
The men are so dashing.
Ah.
Thanks to my new dress code, the fashion's never clashing. Hey, naughty, 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 no. This castle I have built always taller than the cliff tops. A city like a postcard with a monorail and gift shops. And so. No one from the gutter in Duloc.
He's taking aim.
Embrace the cookie cutter in Duloc.
We're all the same.
The upshot is enormous when you can shout. Yes, things are looking up here in Duloc. Hey, let's hear it for those Duloc dancers. Aren't they terrific, huh? Ha! Six, Squish, Cicero, Fosse, Burr.
Hey!
Wow! All right, shimmy to the sky. Come on! Huh. Ah! Ah! Ha! Ah. Huh. Thank you! I'll be here all day! There's no sign of slowing. We're growing!
He's growing! Brr.
Things are looking up.
Things are looking up.
Things are looking up. Here in Duloc. Here in Duloc. I'm ready. Bring in the cookie.
What's going on? Where am I? Hello? Hello? It's you!
Run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man.
Look what you've done to my legs. You're a monster.
I'm not the monster here. You are. You and the rest of that fairy tale trash poisoning my perfect kingdom.
It's not a kingdom, because you're not a king.
Oh, but I will be, just as soon as I find a princess to marry. And I hear you know of one. Tell me where she is.
Eat me!
Gross. No. I've tried to be fair to you creatures, but now my patience has reached its end.
Well, okay. Maybe I have heard tell of a princess.
From who?
Do you know the Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man.
Yes, I know the Muffin Man who lives on Drury Lane.
Well, I heard it from the Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
He heard it from the Muffin Man!
Can I go now?
You haven't told me where she is.
I can't.
You must.
I won't.
Tell me or I'll...
No. Not the buttons. Not my gumdrop buttons.
Then where is the princess?
Okay, I'll tell you. It's about a day's walk from here in a dragon-guarded castle surrounded by hot, boiling lava. In the highest room in the tallest tower, you'll find a fiery redhead named Princess Fiona.
Ooh, Princess Fiona. She sounds perfect, except for that dragon and lava thing. I'll have to find somebody else to go.
I should probably mention a little thing that happens to the princess at night.
Silence! I shall make Fiona my queen, and Duloc will finally have the perfect king. Captain, round up your men, summon the citizens, and bring that cookie to the swamp.
The swamp? This is the thanks I get!
Thelonious, tell the royal coiffure I need to get my hair pressed. We're going to get a queen! And now, good people of Duloc, the moment you've all been waiting for, the raffle drawing to determine who will have the honor of setting forth to rescue the lovely Princess Fiona from the fiery keep of the dragon. Arr! Spin that barrel!
Excuse me.
Oh! Oh!
Oh! Roar.
OMG, you run away.
Hey! Huh? Are you Lord Farquaad?
Maybe. Does the name strike fear in your heart?
No, but that little hat does.
Who let this thing in here?
Look, I'll re-order your silky hair just as soon as you give me my swamp back.
Your swamp?
Yes, where you dropped all those fairy tale creatures.
Newsflash, ogre. That oozing mud pit is actually within the province of Duloc, and therefore under my jurisdiction.
Now listen here, half
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Oh, this is too perfect.
What is?
You! You're big and hulking and wonderfully expendable. People of Duloc, we have a winner! Congratulations, ogre! You've won the honor of embarking on a great and noble quest.
Ooh, but we're already on a quest.
You got to get my swamp back.
Yes, and you've nearly accomplished it. All you need to do is one more simple little task, and I'll hand over the deed to your swamp.
And what exactly is this little task?
Well, there's just this little package I need picked up. Miss Duloc, fill them in and show them out. My people, your queen is on her way. Things are looking up.
Things are looking up.
Things are looking up here in Duloc.
Here in Duloc.
And no one's gonna bring me down.
Are very simple. Whoever spots a horse and cart along the road, punch buggy!
Ow!
Fun, right?
No. What kind of insane game is that?
Haven't you ever been on a road trip?
No.
Man, you need to get out more because punch buggy!
Ow!
I got you. I got you with that wagon full of hay over there.
Tonky, if you do that one more time, I'm...
See, that's another reason you need me around. Who else is going to fill you in on all the fun stuff you missed out on? You may not know it, but you're one lucky ogre to meet up with such a handsome
punch
devil
buggy!
Of a donkey.
Oh! Mutton cart at 3 o'clock.
Mother Hubbard, that hurts!
You know, that was pretty fun. Shall we play again?
No, that's okay. You win. Maybe we should move on to I Spy or I Went on a Picnic or something that isn't going to put me in a body cast.
You are so odd.
Not as odd as you agreeing to go on this quest. What do you know about rescuing a princess anyway?
I've heard the stories.
And I've read the sports page. That don't make me a hockey player.
Oh, come on. Dragon, tower, how hard can it be?
I bet we're gonna find out, I'll tell you that.
Donkey, look. Lord Farquaad's castle. It's a bit much, isn't it? Do you think he might be compensating for something? Oh, forget it.
What's it say about the princess anyway?
Well, apparently she likes pina coladas and getting caught in the rain.
Ooh, she sounds fun. What else?
She's been locked in a tower since she was 7 years old.
Oh, that's so sad. All alone since she was 7 years old. Sad to be all alone in the world.
You are so weird.
Waffle.
That's just like me. Poor Rapunzel needs a haircut, but the witch won't set her free. She passes time by singing like someone else I know. As years go by, she sits and waits. As years go by? Uh-oh, a torturous existence. I don't remember this part. She wishes she was dead. Skip ahead, but in the end, the princess finds a millionaire. The prince is good at climbing and braiding golden hair. So I know he'll appear, 'cause there are rules and there are strictures. I believe the storybooks I read by candlelight, my white knight. I know it's today. I know it's today.
Here's a good one. It's a classic. There's a princess in a coma. Glad it's her instead of me. Does she pee? Blah, 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 blah. Poison apple. Boring, boring, evil queen. Filler, filler, bend their red. That's seven shorties on a scene. Skip ahead, skip ahead. But in the end, the princess wakes up with a start. The prince is good at kissing and melting snow. I know it's today. He'll show up today. There's a princess, any princess. Take your pick, they're all like me. Not exactly, I'm still waiting. They're all living happily. Ever after, better get. I want love in seconds flat. No one needs these middle bits. Whoops,
Did I do that? Cut the villains, cut the vamping, cut this fairy tale, cut the peril and the pitfalls, cut the puppet and the whale, cut the monsters, cut the curses, keep the intro, cut the verses, and the waiting, the waiting, the waiting, the waiting, the waiting! But I know he'll appear, though I seem a bit bipolar.
Why didn't you just make Farquaad give you your swamp back? You know, pull some of that ogre stuff on him. Throttle him. Lay siege to his fortress. You know, the whole ogre trip.
For your information, donkey, there's a lot more to ogres than people think.
Example.
Example? Ogres are like onions.
They stink.
Yes, no.
They make you cry.
No.
You leave them out in the sun, they get all brown and start sprouting their white hairs.
No! Layers. Onions have layers. Ogres have layers. Onions have layers. Ogres have layers. You get it? We both have layers.
Oh, you both have layers. Okay. Ooh, you know, not everybody like onions. Parfaits! Everybody likes parfaits and they have layers. Have you ever met a person and you say, hey, let's get some parfaits, and they say, hell no, I don't like no parfaits. Parfaits are delicious.
I don't care. Ogres are not like parfaits.
Parfaits may be the most delicious thing on the whole damn planet.
This may turn out to be the longest day of my entire life.
I got the perfect remedy for that.
Oh no, I'm not interested.
Sing a song, yes, a travel song, when you gotta go somewhere, 'cause the fun is getting there. Yeah. What the heck, I must confess, I love a road trip. Sing a song, hit the trail, forget the maps, forget the guides, before you know it, you made strides with me. And I know all I need all along is a pass and a pal and a song, so I'm singing and I'm palling with you. See, makes the time go by faster.
Why me? Why me?
This is nice.
Now tell me, what was my crime?
We are stolen.
He's as chatty as a parrot, more annoying than a mime.
Hey, look, a cat who's wearing boots, that's crazy.
Why me? Why me? A simple answer would be fine.
This is good cardio.
Won't someone please send me a sign?
Hey, look, a sign. You need a Pad Avenue straight ahead.
What did I do to deserve this honestly? This ass of mine is asinine. Why me?
Oh, you see, little bunny.
Ah, it looks delicious.
Ah, don't eat me, please.
What's so funny?
I just got the whole he might be compensated for something joke.
song hit.
Why me?
The road.
A simple answer.
It's the way to go around.
Before you know someone it, please send me a sign. What did I do to deserve this honesty?
Is a pen and a pan and a song to
this ass
singing.
Of mine.
Hello, dear.
His ass is nine.
Sweet.
Why am I with you?
Warm breeze?
Aye.
It came up so suddenly.
That's because we're on a bridge, donkey.
I didn't even notice. What bridge is this?
The bridge to the Dragon's Keep.
Oh, the bridge to the Dragon's Keep. So that intense heat I'm feeling coming up from under me.
That should be the Lake of Molten Lava.
The Lake of Molten Lava?
Donkey.
We're on a rickety bridge over a Lake of Molten Lava.
Donkey, you'll be fine. And whatever you do, don't look down.
Chuck, I'm looking down!
Oh,
I'm also a terror!
Look into my eyes!
I can't.
Just take my
I
hand!
Can't.
Just take a step!
I can't.
Now walk.
Okay, bud. Don't let me go. Don't let me go.
I won't let you go. I won't let you go.
What did I do to deserve you, my pal, evermore? We crossed the bridge together. What a beautiful metaphor.
Oh, I'm singing,
and I'm happy, and I'm traveling with you.
That'll do, donkey. That'll do.
You? Man, you gotta warn somebody before you just crack one off. My mouth is open and everything.
Believe me, Donkey, if it was me, you'd be dead. It's brimstone.
Yeah, right. Brimstone. Don't be talking, it's a brimstone. I know what I smell, and it wasn't no brimstone. Didn't come from no stone, neither.
This will come in handy. Hope it's fireproof. Now you just stay right there and I'll be right back.
Wait, you mean by myself?
Unless you'd like to come rescue the princess and slay the dragon.
No, I'm good. Waiting's fine. But hurry back. Man, this place is creepy. Shrek? Shrek, was that you?
Well, hello. Gorgeous.
Is it dinner time already?
I better get my recipe box.
Recipe box?
What's your name?
Mommy!
What a coincidence! That was his name too!
And his, and his, and his!
You didn't knock when you entered, baby. You didn't wipe your feet.
Oh, geez.
I did not see no open house sign.
Is this trick or treat? Brush up on fairy tales, friend, cause dry like their sleep.
Come on, grab them, shut up.
I wrote the book on fire breathing. Why don't you read it and weep?
I'm not sure where the book
is. Weep, weep, weep. I'm gonna shake you. I'm gonna bake you. I'm gonna make you my donkey pot pie.
What?
Sounds very stinky. I'll probably flake you. I'll pancake you. My donkey pot.
So sparkling white. I bet you hear this from all of your food, but you must bleach at night. Is that a hint of minty freshness? Oh, I am scared to death. I like a girl with a dazzling smile and tic-tac on her breath. Oh, oh, oh. Don't kill me. Lady with the pretty teeth.
Gonna love you.
Oh.
And take hold of you.
Slow down, baby.
I'll velvet glove you.
Velvet glove me.
My donkey pot pie. I'm gonna keep you.
today. Ooh, I know it's today. Ooh, I know it's today.
Ooh. Oh, is anybody up there? Shouldn't you drop your hair down or something? Oh, I should have worn my cup. Oh, look, I got one of the snoozers. Wait! Are you Princess Fiona?
I am, awaiting a knight so bold as to rescue me.
Great, now let's go.
Oh, now holdest on, Sir Knight. I have long awaited this day, and I wouldest first like to knowest the name of my champion.
Shrek.
Sir Shrek, I pray that you take this favor as a token of my gratitude.
Thanks. So, where's the door?
There is no door.
What? Then how do we get down?
Why, the same way you got up.
The same way I... Oh, come on, I mean, I just... Very well.
Hold us on, Sir Shrek. Don't you want to savor this moment? It beeth our first meeting. It must be a wonderful and romantic scene.
Oh, gee, I'm like a crackpot magnet.
This is how a dream comes true. This is how I pictured you climbing in to rescue me. This was always meant to be.
That's great, Princess. Now hop on.
This is how the scene must go. There, the light, just so. Then you smile and gaze at me. Take my hand on bended knee. Bended knee. Bended knee. Sorry. And though we've only met, somehow I always knew it would look like this when dreams come true.
Come on!
Where are we going?
I have to save my ass.
Excuse me? Sir Knight, slow down a bit. Shucks, and girls are delicate. I've longed for this my whole life long. Now you're doing it all wrong. Down a rope, a speed awaits. That's what every story states. Grinding over rough terrain. Past the dragon you have slain. You have slain. You have slain.
It's on my to-do list.
What?
No. Get away. That is an unwanted physical contact. I do not give permission to touch me there.
Dragon!
Just relax and take a breath. Hope he doesn't burn to death. Never mind the protocol. He's your hero after all. Tra-la-la-la-la, what's past is past. Tra-la-la-la-la, I'm free at last. In the end, the princess always gets her man. And underneath that helmet, I bet he has a tan. My champion, my Zager, my dashing Romeo. He has a talking donkey, that part I didn't know. Wait a minute, look, it's just like in the book. They're fighting over me, like it's meant to be. No more tower in the sky, slay the dragon and goodbye. Oh my God, we're gonna die! Find your way at last. My dream comes true. Oh, I knew. It would be today.
amazing. You're wonderful. You're a little unorthodox, I'll admit, but thy deed is great and thine heart is pure. I am eternally in your debt. And where would a brave knight be without his noble steed?
All right, I hope you heard that, Sheik. She called me a noble steed. She'd think I'm a steed.
Well, Sir Shrek, the battle is won. You may remove your helmet.
No.
Why not?
I have helmet hair.
Please, I wouldest look upon the face of my champion.
Oh, no, you wouldn't.
But how will you kiss me?
Kiss you? No, that wasn't in the job description.
Maybe it's a perk.
No, it's destiny. A princess is rescued by a brave knight, and then the two share true love's first kiss.
Shrek? You think Shrek's the true love?
What's so funny?
Let me just say, I'm not your type, okay?
Of course you are. You're my rescuer. Now remove your helmet.
Look, I really don't think that's a good idea.
Just take off
I'm
the
not
helmet.
Going
take
to.
It off.
No!
No!
Wait! Fine. As you command, Your Highness.
You're an ogre.
Are you expecting Prince Charming?
Well, yes, actually. I'm supposed to be rescued by my true love, not by some ogre and his pet.
Oh, well, so much for noble steed.
You're not supposed to be an ogre.
Well, listen, little princess. I was sent here by Lord Farquaad, all right? Yeah, he is the one who wants to marry you.
Then why didn't he come rescue me?
Good question. You should ask him that when we get there, tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Oh my gosh, it's almost sunset.
So?
I didn't realize it was getting so late. We need to make camp.
Camp, but you just escaped.
Yes, and I found the whole ordeal quite exhausting. I need to rest immediately.
That's too bad, because we're going to keep going.
I need to find somewhere to camp right now.
All right.
There's a cave right over there. Oh, Shrek, that is no place for a princess.
Oh, no. It's perfect. Well, gentlemen, I bid thee good night.
You want me to read you a bedtime story? Because I will.
I said good night.
She seems nice.
By day, one way. By night, another. This shall be the norm. Until you find true love's first kiss. And then take love's true form.
It's what I realized. If we escaped a dragon, then we could do anything. Man, I could be a steed if I wanted to. Or I could work the crusade circuit. I could even be one of those horses that pull those wagons full of beer. I need some hair extensions on my ankles, but I could do it. Who do you want to be?
I wouldn't want to be anyone.
But if you had to pick.
I wouldn't.
Just for fun, though.
Donkey!
Like if a guy had a sword in his throat and was like, oh, look here, you can't be an ogre anymore. Pick something else and then get to the chapel. Then who'd you pick?
I would pick that guy up and hurl him into a tree.
Man, you are no fun at all, you know what? Is this what it's gonna be like when we finish rescuing the princess? Sitting around our swamp all day doing nothing?
Our swamp? Donkey, there is no hour. There is no we. There is just me and my swamp. And the first thing I'm going to do when I get back is build a 10-foot wall around my land.
You cut me deep, Shrek. Cut me real deep just now. What's your problem anyway? What do you got against the whole world?
I'm not the one with the problem, all right? It's the world who seems to have a problem with me. You see the way the princess reacted. That's how it always is. People take one look at me and it's, oh, help! A big, stupid, ugly ogre! They judge me before they even know me. That's why I'm better off alone.
But you know what, Shrek? When we first met, I didn't think he was just a big, stupid, ugly ogre.
Yeah, I know.
So there's really no one else you'd rather be?
I guess I'd be a hero
sword and armor clashing, looking semi-dashing, shield within my grip, or else I'd be a Viking and live a life of daring, smelling like a herring. Upon a Viking ship, I'd sail away, I'd see the world, I'd reach the farthest reaches, I'd feel the wind, I'd taste the salt and sea, and maybe storm some beaches. That's who I'd be. That's who I'd be. Or I could be a poet and write a different story, one that tells of glory and wipes away the lies. Into the skies I throw it, the stars would do the telling, the moon would help with spelling, and night would dot the eyes. I'd write a verse, recite a joke, pretend perfect timing. I'd share my heart, confess the things I yearn, and do it all while rhyming. But we all learn. But we all learn. An ogre always hides. An ogre's fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark and all alone. So yes, I'd be a hero. And if my wish were granted, life would be enchanted, or so the stories say. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower to save a hothouse flower and carry her away. But standing guard would be a beast, I'd somehow overwhelm it. I'd get the girl, I'd take a breath, and I'd remove my helmet. We stand and stare, we speak of love, we'd feel the stars ascending. We'd share a kiss, I'd find my destiny. I'd have a hero's ending. A perfect happy ending. That's how it would be. A big, bright, beautiful world. But not for.
Ladies and gentlemen, there will now be a 20-minute intermission. Thank you.